By default, these are preset titles on the layout masters, but you can change or create new ones at any time. Double-click the A4 portrait layout to open it. In this view, you have access to its content. You can place any 2D content here, including text, fills, lines, images, etc. You can also copy and paste these elements from one master layout to another. Zoom in to the lower area of this master layout. You can see normal text and text with the number sign at the beginning. These texts are so-called auto-text elements. The advantage of using these elements is to retrieve information from BIM instead of typing the text manually. Let's see what information we can use as auto-text. Delete all text from the first two cells of the top row as presented on the screen. Activate the text tool in the toolbox and double-click in the empty cell of the title block. The text editor palette appears. Click the A, Insert Auto Text button. An organized list of available information appears. You can sort them by category. Let's fill in the client data in the empty field of the title block. Select client details in the category list. Select client full name from the list below as an auto text item. Click the Insert button to insert this into the text field. Select the inserted auto text and use the black pen color. Press Enter once. Insert another auto text item. Select client address 1 from the list and click Insert. Set the font height to 2 millimeters and its style to regular. Press Enter and insert additional auto text entries as presented on the screen. Insert client city client country client postcode. Use the formatting tools, like the pen and text alignment. Press Enter to start a new row. Click outside the text editor box to place the text. Reposition and stretch the text box as presented on the screen. The information displayed here comes from the Project Info dialog box. To define the information, open File, Info, Project Info dialog. Enter Training Series 3 to the project name field. You may fill out more fields and see how those are updated. Click OK. Notice that the project name auto text entry now displays Training Series 3 on the master layout. There are some other fields related to layout properties. These will be filled only when you create a layout based on the master. Delete the middle part of the middle line between the empty cells. You may use the split as well as the adjust commands from the toolbar. Now we'll create a new master layout for the details and visualization. On these layouts, we will place multiple drawings, and we want them to adjust automatically. Click the New Master Layout button in the layout book of the Navigator. Type A4 Landscape as the name on the Name and Size panel of the dialog. Select the A4 ISO metric size from the size list. Select the Landscape option. Display the Drawing Placement panel. Select the Align and Assign Drawings to a Grid option. Click the Grid Setup button. In the Grid Setup dialog, change the following. Enter 2 for the number of vertical and horizontal cells. Click the down arrow in front of the letters at the Direction and Style panel. Select the Dense Dotted Line Style for the grid line type. Select the Show All option for the grid line display. Finally, select the top right option for the ID display regarding drawings that occupy multiple cells. Click OK. Check the Set as Default for New Layouts box, and click Create to proceed. Select the top item in the layout book. Create a new layout subset. Enter renderings for its name in the Subset Identification panel. Click Create. Open the organizer. Display the layout book on the right side. Create a new layout in the layout. Enter renderings for the name of the new layout as well. Click Create. Drag and drop the newly created renderings layout to the rendering subset if necessary. Display the view map on the left side of the organizer. Drag four of the rendered views on the renderings layout. Select Entrance White and Sketch, as well as Back CineRender and Interior CineRender. Close the organizer. The views are positioned according to the grid, but currently they are too big. Select the renderings on the layout and open their settings dialog. Display the size and appearance panel. Set the magnification to 30%. Display the title panel. Select the no title option from the list. Click OK to apply all these changes. As you can see, the renderings on the layout are not the rendered images we would like to display here. Display the view map of the navigator. Select all four rendering views you inserted on the layout earlier. Open their view settings dialog. Display the 3D only panel. Select the Generate In Photo Rendering Window option. Click OK to apply this change. This will ensure that all four images on the layout will be displayed using the rendering engines and settings you defined in the previous chapter of this guide. Display the layout book in the navigator. Select the renderings folder, right-click, and select Update from the context menu. ARCHICAD will now render all four images using the previously adjusted settings. This may take a minute or two. The project layout book will always be automatically updated as the project develops, since all the drawings and sheets are linked to their source master content. So if any of the source information changes, ARCHICAD will instantly regenerate and update all the layouts automatically.